Country Closeup continues, and we're going to be joined by Earl Thomas Conley. But first, we're going to hear his hit, Somewhere Between Right and Wrong.
Always gone. Said the only way to get to him was a telephone. So she held on to me when she couldn't hold her own. She said, I can be had, but I can't be bought. And I can be bad, Lord, if I don't get.
Thomas Conley, Somewhere Between Right and Wrong, and welcome to the show. As always, it's good to see you.
Thank you, sir. It's a pleasure to be here.
I'm trying to remember the last time we talked. I think it was over a year ago. So maybe the best place to start is, what's ETC been doing in the last year, besides having hit records?
Well, we're building a house on 62 acres, and I'm looking forward to being a country boy again. Haven't lived in the country since I was 14 years old, so anxious to see what influence it's going to have on me, my music.
That's great.
But we got the Greatest Hits album out, and this was to give me an opportunity to have time to create a whole bunch of songs for this June release album that I'm supposed to have ready by then, hopefully.
The Greatest Hits package, does that have any new songs on it?
Well, Nobody Falls Like a Fool and Once in a Blue Moon were the two outside singles. It was real interesting to put these songs together in a 5-year period of time and say, well, I didn't know I sang that song like that. Because you change.
Yeah.
Hopefully you change, you know. You grow and you learn new things all the time and try new techniques. But this year I've never suffered writer's block as bad as I am. I say this every year, don't I?
I want to talk more about that. Right now, though, I want to play a song that we were talking about, Once in a Blue Moon. This is Earl Thomas Conley on Country Closeup.
Nine times out of ten, she's right and I am wrong. And when I won't give in, she just goes along. Standing by my side, sitting home alone. I'll never know what keeps her hanging on. When anybody else would be long gone. But once in a blue moon, I'll do something right. And once in
Earl Thomas Conley and Once in a Blue Moon. Earl's going to rejoin us a little bit later in the show. Up next, some country notes. That's after this on Country Close-Up. Country Close-Up continues. I'm Lon Helton, and our guest is Earl Thomas Conley. And the, are you where you want to be? I mean, or do you think you'd be?
No, thank goodness. If I was, then I'd start to be boring and unrefreshing and have to get out of the business. I want to sell a platinum album. And I want to get back to writing some message songs. I like to sit down and write one by myself again. Someday I want to get involved in film a little more, other than doing videos. Those are fun to do, but I don't feel like I just haven't accomplished what I want to do. Where our fans are accumulating in our shows, I'm working with Hank Jr. all the time now, most all the time when he's out. I'm opening for him, and we've had real good crowd success. And the records are selling better and better every day. I feel like I'm on an upswing, and the energy's real good and everything, but I want to sell a million records on one song rather than an accumulation of albums.
Yeah, and that just means that you're touching a lot more people.
Yeah, I think you got to set new goals for yourself. Hopefully the day that I get bored with this and tired of it, I do it before it shows up in my music and I realize it and I don't do this. I get off into something else, but I feel like a kid. I feel like I've just gotten started.
In and out of honky-tonks, from one town to the next. But anything worth loving, Lord's just too hard to forget.
Fire and Smoke and Earl Thomas Conley here on Country Closeup. Are you, is it tougher to please you now writing?
Yeah, it would be real easy for me if I don't watch myself. It's much more convenient, I'll put it that way. Because as long as these people are bringing in songs to these other writers. Back when I first started, one reason why it was important that I wrote was because a lot of people didn't, you didn't get the best songs. You got the songs that everybody else had turned down, and that's no way to build a career. And now I get the cream of the crop, because people are getting into what I've done before, mm-hmm. and they've got my style down to the point where they can write for me now, and I get real good songs pitched to me. But it ruins you as a writer because you become lazy. You say, well, I can always depend on these guys now, but later on, when the energy shifts, I'll be out there on a limb. I'll be out there on a limb if something would go wrong, and then I would have lost. If you wait over a year or 2 years without writing a song yourself, it's much harder to come back and start and get that energy going again. So it's real important that all the outside songs that I cut are the best that I can find, and continue to write myself and keep that alive, mm-hmm. because that way I can keep myself from getting too plastic.
Way up in the sky, moons and planets fly, comets streak and shooting stars fall down. But I'm just sitting here, sipping on my second beer, and doing my stargazing on the ground. We're all
Bodies from our guest Earl Thomas Conley, who's going to be back with us in a minute on Country Closeup. We're back on Country Closeup. I'm Lon Helton with Earl Thomas Conley. And Earl, let's talk about you and videos. What do you like most about doing them?
Those videos stuff are so much fun.
Yeah?
Really fun. You get a chance on this last one. We didn't do any lip syncing or anything, and it was kind of an unusual twist. I got to play a drunk on the front part of it. But it's just real fun to learn how to deal with expressions, your facial expressions and stuff. It will be some nice to sit down with a script someday and get into a film, you know, get into a movie project.
You have actively pursuing that? I mean, have you done screen tests or anything like that?
No, I've kind of run away from any conversations that lead to that, really, because I haven't done with my music. And I don't want my music to suffer for that until I'm ready to get over into that.
I get a sense from you now that I didn't get 2 or 3 years ago when we talked. I mean, a much more
is it fair
aggressive.
Or responsibility?
No.
Desire.
I'm just going to grab it and do it because you want to do it and you believe you can do it. I mean, it's just a...
I think that life is what you make it. And if that's the case, if I'm right, it's important that I take charge and create good things for myself in the future. And that way it'll always be enjoyable. And now that I see that you can actually do this, the sky's the limit. You can really do this. It's fun.
That's what they mean by confidence, I guess. Listen, thank you very much for being here. I hope when the new album comes out that we can get together again and talk about all the songs in it.
I hope so.
Thank you.
I've enjoyed it a lot.
Thanks, Earl.
It's the third hardest thing I'll ever do. And even here, without you. And the second hardest thing I'll ever do is telling her about you. She's been good to me when things were going well. How can I tell her now the good ain't good enough? Oh, the hardest thing I've ever had to do is holding her and loving you. If she'd give me one good reason, I'd be gone. But she ain't done one thing wrong. So don't expect me just to walk out of the door. I still love her, but I love you more. She's been good to me. Things weren't going right. She made my days long before you made my nights. So the hardest thing I've ever had to do is holding her and loving you.
Number one song for our guest, Earl Thomas Conley. Of course, thanks to Earl and the Forrester Sisters for spending a little bit of time with us this week. Now, next time out, we've got a very special conversation with Waylon Jennings. He talks about his new album and his new outlook on life. Waylon Jennings, next week here on Country Close-Up, brought to you in part by Chevy Trucks and by the Army National Guard, the irresistible force celebrating its 350th anniversary. Country Close-Up is a Narwood production, Ellen Silver producer, Dave LeVan engineer, Rhonda Yellin associate producer, and Ted LeVan executive producer. I'm Lon Helton, and we'll see you next week right here on Country Close-Up.